Actually, one of my brahmacharini, when we were going in caravan, in those days, when I was living in India, I used to go in caravan and all these, my kids, boys and girls, Gurukul kids, all of them will be sitting with me, and that used to be a fun time for them, where they'll be laughing, joking, teasing. One of my kid asked me, "Swamiji, can you get ice cream for all of us?" I said, as a father, I won't say no. Get the ice cream and eat. But as a guru, I will not say yes. Because this habit of small, small things triggering and those parasites triggering you and you fulfilling them. When you start feeling this as a cute and freedom, that is what is the life, you are gone. I tell you, I said, as a father, I won't say no. But as guru, I will not say yes. Do not feel cute about parasites triggering your muscle memory and you acting as the parasites are pushing you. No! Once your parasites feel empowered, you are going to do what they trigger in you. They move their ground, they go deeper into you from your muscle memory to bio memory. They get deeply rooted, they get grounded into your belief about you, into your memory about you. They grow roots from your muscle memory to bio memory. Listen, the parasites grown in bio memory level are that suicidal tendencies. You are ready even to die, but not ready to come out of many of your delusions and beliefs. I have seen people, they are ready to die, but they don't want to get out of their frustration, their anger, their vengeance. See this. Multiple examples I can give you. In Mahabharata, the Bhishma's enemy, Drishtadyumna's sister, Shikhandi, she is actually Napumsaka. She takes birth again just to kill Bhishma. Means, even after death, she is not ready to give up her anger. Understand? When the parasites sit in your bio memory level, they become part of your very cognition about you. The very cognition about you, that is the most dangerous. That's the most dangerous.